Hey guys, Richie here from RW Hobbies. Welcome back for my May bench update. So, usual format, this is going to be a little short and sweet. Only really one big project to talk about. You see the tail here on the corner, and I think many of you know what it is. Before we do that, a little bit of housekeeping, and if you've not already done so, please hit the subscribe button to get updates on my latest videos, all that kind of stuff. And second piece is subtitles. So Wayne Green over at Walden Wayne did a video a couple of months ago about adding subtitles or closed captions to YouTube videos. And I honestly thought they were just automatic. They just show up in the country you're in and automatically creates it. But there's actually a few steps you have to do for each language to activate it. So a few of my videos went back and added some generic, well, not generic, but more popular languages, things like German, French, Spanish, Japanese and Korean, I think I added, and Swedish to my Viggen build. But if you are not an English speaker and you want me to add subtitles to your particular language on my videos, just put a note in the comments below or shoot me an email, let me know, I'm happy to do so. It's just the way the system works, a little bit convoluted. You can't just turn on all 100 languages and have them do it. You have to go for each language individually and click on it and update and auto translate each one, which takes some time. So I don't know why YouTube doesn't automatically just update every video with the language, because the technology obviously is there. So so that's subtitles. So that's my little housekeeping bit out of the way, as always. Now let's move on to what I've been working on. No finished builds, as you can see in a minute, reason why I've got the Viggen. So I'll show you in a minute. So last month I talked about losing the mojo, wasn't really into it. So what? 2 days later, what do? I pulled out the most expensive kit I have in my stash, the limited edition 1 of 500. It's actually number 8 of 500, and that's the 1/32nd scale Jetmads Viggen. Love the Viggen, as you guys know on the channel. Really excites me, that aircraft, and it's been a lot of work and a lot of fun to work on. So things massive, and without further ado, let me kind of show you what I've been up to the past month. And here she is. Massive, right? It's heavy, it's resin, all 100% resin or 3D printed. Finally got it together and ready to go put the canopy on and get the thing painted maybe tomorrow, which I'm very excited for. Obviously that beautiful Swedish leaf camo scheme. But there she is, beautiful aircraft, just a beast, raw power. Think these guys, you know, park in the forest and just take off on roads and stuff, and very impressive aircraft, and I've really enjoyed working on this one. Now the kit, not for a beginner by any means. It's been a month of sanding and filling and fitting and working resin. It's been a lot of work, but I can see the light at the end of the tunnel. And yeah, again, there she is, massive, right? Beast. So I put the thing together mostly with, well, almost solely with epoxy, to be honest with you. Bob Smith's 5-minute epoxy. So any resin kits, highly recommend. Just mix these 50-50, and actually a little bit more than 5 minutes. Probably takes about 8 minutes to go off, but this has like a tensile strength of like 3,500 pounds per inch or something. So if I use super glue, I'll be worried if I hold it by the wing like this, it'd probably snap off. Whereas this stuff is a beast. I mean, it's really strong. So used that, and it, like I say, it's about 8 minutes and it sets. And when I first started, I'm not really a big epoxy user, I've not really used it much. And silly me, what I did was I put epoxy in the parts, hold it together, you know, wait 5 minutes for it to dry. And I thought, well, why am I doing that? So what I realized was it takes 5 to 8 minutes to dry. So I'd put the glue on the pieces and then walk away, watch some TV or do something, then come back 4 minutes later and then hold it for 1 minute rather than holding it for 5 minutes. So there you go. So that's what we did. Got this thing together. Still needs a little bit of work, a few seam lines. You can see where I've painted, just to see, you know, how I'm looking. You spray some primer on certain areas. Well, that's why it's all supposed to blotchy in there. But yeah, really liking it. Another issue I had to last few days was the nose cone. I put in, didn't say any nose weight, but I put in 1 ounce fishing weight. I had some Mod Podge, some PVA glue in there, and it just wouldn't dry. I left it 3 days and the glue just finally started to dry. So it's on hold for a little bit too. But yeah, there we are. Awesome, right? Going back to the kit, the 3D printed parts, well, pretty well fitting, pretty good. But the actual cast resin, which is this, you know, this stuff here, you have to cut it from the block, sand it, a lot of work. As always, you see in my video series on this, I did it in a kitchen sink and washed all the stuff down the drain. And what even though I cleaned up afterwards, 2 or 3 days later, I still find resin dust appear, like ghost resin dust appear around the sink, and just dust is everywhere. It's definitely a messy job, indeed. So a piece coming loose there. But yeah, it's went together. Really the evolution of builds, because you think the growler, which is on right now, that took 30 seconds ago, trumpeter kit, that took a little bit of finagling. The Harrier trumpeter certainly took a lot of work, and that really led me up to this stage to get this guy together. And again, you know, we're dealing with a lot of gaps and stuff, but just some filler, some old school modeling tips, and we're together. So I definitely want to buy more Jetmads kits. I think they bring out a 32nd scale F22 next couple of years. That definitely on my wish list. Not something I'll build every single week. I think maybe one of these every couple of years or so. But I definitely looking forward to going back to some plastic and working some plastic kits. Less messy and going to get a little bit easier. But yeah, there we go. Let's put this down before I break it. This morning, I was relieved to get past the scariest part of the kit, and that was cutting the canopy away from the giant casting blocks. So got them cut off, no problem at all. And basically, you know, the usual technique of using my saw, zoner saw, cutting about 2 or 3 mil away from the line, and just my sanding sticks coming back and sanding it to that line. Another top tip, which I talk about in the video too, is clever putty. So if any kind of blue tack or putty, what I did with this stuff was I just basically put it inside the canopy when I worked on it. So when I was cutting it, so it absorbs some of that tension and stuff. So I'm not going to crack it so easily, because you've got something inside it. It's not going to be not hollow. So it made it a little bit more safer to work with, I think. So that's that way. That's done. Talking of which, all pretty much up to date now on Patreon. So if you want to watch the build series or this, the full build series on Patreon, 5 parts are up already. Part number 6, which gets me to that stage, goes up on Wednesday morning at 10 a.m. Eastern time. So every week or so, I put up on Patreon the build series. Again, all 5 parts are up there. If you want Patreon, links below, again, in the video below. I'm noticing too in my camera there, it's when right at sunset, because when I filmed this, when I started filming this 7 minutes ago, it was sunlight, and now it's like dark outside. So that's interesting, right? That's pretty much it with a Viggen. Trying to think what else. What have I purchased? Not much, because I've been working on that, plus working on buying a house. So I'm not spending a bunch of money on kits and stuff right now. But one thing I did get was this guy, Maestro Models mask set for the Viggen. This wasn't cheap. This was like $45 for 3 pieces of mask, which is very expensive indeed, but it's essential. Like, no way am I masking this camo up by hand. So you got 3 sheets, and then probably over this weekend I'll start masking this up and getting this painted, this beautiful skin, excuse me. Yeah, so I got that one from Sweden. You can buy it from different places, but I actually found just buying from direct was the cheapest price actually from Sweden, cheaper than Hammonds and some other places. But yeah, some interesting shaped paper, very long and skinny. I guess it's some kind of European size. And then, you know, the other thing I received in the mail, which I didn't pay for, but I got for free, was finally Revell, my Tornado decals, the 32nd scale Tornado. So a few people have asked me about it. If you remember back around January time, I started building the Revell 32nd scale Tornado GR1 in the wraparound camo. I didn't have my decals for the cockpit. So I reached out to them and they said they'll get me decals within 6 weeks. 12 weeks passed, I still haven't received them. So I emailed them again. They said, we'll get another set sent out to you. They probably got lost. And within like 2 or 3 weeks, I got this set. So finally got them. So once this guy's done, then I'll probably switch and work on the Tornado, which I think is gonna be a dream to work on after working on this guy. So Tornado, love 32nd scale jets coming up. So Tornado will be, I think, right, once we've got this guy done, cleaned up and out of the way. And yeah, that's pretty much it. What else? That's it. So let me switch to my Facebook page, my Facebook group, and we'll look at a few projects on there, and then we'll come back. Okay, so going around the page, as always, on Facebook, again, the link is below, and 5 things I picked out this month, and the first one is Dan and his Firebird. It was actually in a magazine, the Phoenix Scale Modeling Magazine, and there we go. Look at this, the magazine article. And it's the Revell 24 scale kit. Look how clean that is. Really nice build.
go. Second up is Kevin and his AMK F14D. I have this one in my stash. I'm always wondering how this one goes together. You gotta love an F14. And you see, with his wings extended, it's massive. I know my Tamiya F14, the aggressor, has the wings extended, and it takes a huge space up. Looking really good, nicely painted and weathered. Just a cool jet F14. Next up, we got Andrew and his Daswerk 16th scale Stug. So 16th scale is going to be pretty massive. So let's take a look at this guy. There we go. And nice kit. I believe it's got a little bit of interior where you see it, but it's not overly loaded with parts. But yeah, looking really good. You can see back there, too, on the kit. You see like the weld seams, the beading. All the screws, it's nicely detailed. Very cool. Next up, a guy called Mr. Bertland, and he has the Fujimi 24 scale Ferrari 250 GTO. Not only is it an amazing car, it always reminds me of the E-Type Jag as well when I see it. But not an amazing car, but I mean, just a flawless build as always. And I know he lost the photo etch for the front, the prancing horse or whatever. I think he lost this part. And I know he got a replacement. I'm seeing why now it's so prominent. That one little bit of photo etch just really makes like the whole car kind of come together. But as always, a flawless build. Amazing shine, 2K. Very, very nice. Finally, Ian, after a little time away from the kitchen table modeling bench, I managed to get back at the trio of Tamiya F, 148th scale British fighter bombers, the Bowfighter and Paramosquitoes. What caught my eye here was the coloring, like this, the way it's painted and the color and the shading, just spot on. I really like this one. The colors just catch my eye, in particular this guy right here, the Beaufort. And then you got the Mosquitoes back here too. Heard of great kits, these Tamiya 48 scale Mozzies as well. And yeah, looking really good. There we go again, just nicely painted and weathered. And there we go. So that's it. Just a quick look around the Facebook group. Again, it's RW Hobbies Model Makers Club. Feel free to post in here anything, any of your work or any questions or anything you might have. Just a small group. I think we're up to like 280 members or so. Actually, I'm going to scroll to the top and see right now. So excuse the scrolling. Do it this way. And we have 272 members right now. So yeah, we just started this in January. This is an opportunity to give back to the community and people share their work or share their projects or their YouTube channels, that kind of stuff. So yeah, that's it for the roundup. And let's go back to me.
So there we go. So awesome as always. Thank you everybody for your support and posting and all that kind of stuff. And once again, if you haven't done so already, please hit the subscribe button and you get latest notifications, get the latest videos, and there's a ton of content on the channel. So thank you as always, have a great weekend, and I'll see you next time.